We went into last night's semi-final confident of making the final. Let's see what happened.
All right, we're ready for a start. Semi-final round. New Zealand, Korea, Australia, and France ready to participate. From lane one will be New Zealand in the black and white. Beside them in lane two, with the line green, Australia. Then in lane three is Korea in blue and yellow, and France will be on the outside. 45 laps the distance. In this first semifinal, two teams to transfer. There you see them, the Netherlands down on the inside. Or rather, New Zealand down on the inside, getting set with the McMillan brothers.
Ready.
Ready for a start. Up, false start.
Official one, false start.
Both the team from Korea and France breaking. That'd be something, they eliminated two teams before we got underway here.
Well,
back to the line. Getting set for another start.
Come on.
And they're calling him back another time before they turn them loose. Peugeot out there for the French team, and on the break, it is New Zealand out in front. Down to the inside. Trying to bust through comes South Korea in the blue and yellow, and they get around the outside and take the lead.
And we've got three great teams in this race. New Zealand second in the world last year, Australia first in the world last year, and Korea won that lightning heat the other day to get them into this semifinal in a world record time.
South Korea, for the moment, has the advantage. Looking very powerful, South Korea drawing away. New Zealand going stride for stride with the Australian team, and France in fourth. Changing almost every lap. Sometimes a lap and a half, but usually it's a lap. And then the big exchange, pushing off, getting 4 or 5 miles per hour.
These three teams in the front now are really going to go at this race from the beginning, because only two are going to qualify. And unlike with the Chinese women the other night, Korea doesn't want to get a lead and then sit back on the pace and let anybody be close in case something happens later on.
Lee Young-ho for the blue and yellow of Korea out in front. Australia stays in second place. And for the Aussies, at the moment, it is Andrew Murpa. They come from all over the continent of Australia. Here's Murpa getting ready to make his exchange. And meanwhile, the Koreans continue to draw away, and New Zealand goes into second spot. The New Zealanders are back.
This is starting to set up like a race between New Zealand and Australia for second place as Korea starts to pull away and France starts to drop off the back of the pack.
Chris Nicholson on the ice for the New Zealand team, keeping them right in there with the Australians. The black and white is that New Zealand team. They've come thousands of miles to compete against each other, and one of New Zealand's standing down on the exchange. It's all right. As he pushed off, Nicholson went down, pushing off his brother.
They'd already made the relay because the skaters had touched each other, and it was the skater leaving the track who had fallen.
Meanwhile, the South Koreans continue to build on this lead. There are 30 laps down. 15 laps remaining. All of a sudden, New Zealand and Australia trying to close ground again. The blue and yellow of South Korea out in front. Song Jae-kyun, one of the fastest skaters they have, ready to make this exchange. And there you see that mad merry-go-round that continues to be the 5,000-meter semifinal round.
There's about a 1.5 to 2 seconds space between the Koreans and the New Zealand and Australia teams.
Korea out in front. The battle is for second place. It's between the folks from down under, New Zealand and Australia, in a war, trying to decide that second transferring position into the finals. For the moment, the Australians are there, but the New Zealanders are matching them stride for stride here in 3 and 4. Mike McMillan, number 51, is on the ice. He skated against Andrew Murtha. The battle is for that second and final transferal into the main event. Meanwhile, the French are gathering power. They're getting back into this event. No contest up in front. South Korea's blazing away.
South Korea has about a 4-second lead at this point in time, Ken. And you're right, France is starting to close the gap.
something is amiss. Back again come the Australians, trying to get back in this thing. As you watch, the Koreans, with now Mo Ji-soon on the ice, about to make the transfer to Lee Yong-ho. The French closing the gap a bit, but there you see the battle. It's between the black and white and the lime green. New Zealand in black and white. The lime green is Australia. The South Koreans well out in front. 3.5 second advantage it remains. And there's the battle for second place. New Zealand on the outside, going up high, trying to get some running room is Tony Smith. Smith is around, and he's taken New Zealand back to second place. On the transfer, it's to Andrew Nicholson. As New Zealand continues to make war out of second spot, what an upset this could be if Australia is eliminated, the defending world champions.
The coach from New Zealand's been working these teams very, very hard through the whole 2 weeks that we've been here. Every day they're out there working on those exchanges, which can make a significant difference by the end of the race.
It's back to 4 seconds by which Korea leads. The story is all in second place. With 14 laps to go. The Australians have had a terrible crash in turn number two. Two of their people are down. You can count this one as over. It'll be South Korea and New Zealand going on.
Australia is out of that race now, because although they're the world champions, there was nobody to cover that fall. There's our skater responsible for the skater on the track, and to cover those falls like that. That should have been much quicker for a world champions.
In the first semifinal, as we get down to the final 10 laps, an amazing situation. As South Korea continues to blaze away with a healthy 4 second advantage. Australia and New Zealand were battling side by side, then a major crash among the Aussies, and New Zealand seems to be on their way to transferring into the 5,000 meter final.
At this point, it starts to get very complicated for the judges, because Australia is in the middle of this race right now, but they are a lap down on Korea, and New Zealand's about to lap them as well.
Kim Ki-hoon on the ice for the South Koreans. You see Australia a lap down as they're making that exchange in the lime green colors. But they had a major incident in turn two that took down two of their competitors and set it up for New Zealand to move on into the finals. Sanjay Kuhn on the ice as we get down to 5 laps remaining in the first 45 lap 5,000 meter contest. South Korea out in front. Mo Ji-soo now takes over for the South Koreans.
The gap between South Korea and New Zealand is about 2 seconds now, but both teams are just working to finish this race on their feet at this point in time. There's no challenge for those two positions. They'll both make the final if they stay up.
Lee Joon-ho on the ice as we get down to 3 laps to go. Gun goes up, one more lap, and then no opportunity to exchange participants in those final 2 laps. You have to stay with that competitor who is on the course. So South Korea should be making one more exchange. They may leave their man out. They have such a big advantage here. South Korea will transfer into the 5,000 men's competition for the championship and the gold medal. And it will be New Zealand coming home for second place.
Again, that's a very good time for South Korea. 7:20. It's not as fast as they went the other day in their heat, but it is still under the existing world record by 2 seconds. What we see here is the battle for second place. Australia in the battle with New Zealand goes down. The skater comes out to make the tag, and he goes down too. And he goes down again. One of the skaters has to touch the other skater before they can enter the race.
Look again at what happened to the Australian team. Down hard went Richard Nozelsky. And with that, it was over for the world champions here in this semifinal round.
Oh dear, it looks worse on replay. Well, soon after that disastrous race, Michael Maher talked with two very disappointed Aussies, John Carr and Kieran Hansen.
Well, you